question is, can I identify the beginning of Ben being an engineer? And I think the answer to that, if you were to ask my wife even, is no, he was always this way. I'm Ben Freireich. I'm a technical fellow at Origin Materials. As a technical fellow, in my role, I serve as a solids processing expert. And what that means is that I'm an internal consultant for all things related to particle technology and solids processing. I developed my very strong love for science and engineering and really problem solving and scoping what engineering meant to me. Taking existing knowledge, engineering and physics, and using that to solve real world challenges. When you ask people, you associate chemical engineering with sustainability. A lot of people look at that and say, no, they're the people causing the problem. You know, you think of oil spills, or you think of microplastics all over the place. Yeah, those are things that were enabled by engineers being able to do stuff when maybe we didn't know any better. But if you step back and you say the sustainability challenges we have going forward, and you try and write down what skill sets are necessary, chemical engineering curriculum is going to come up as being important to solve problems like global warming. Mentorship in engineering is incredibly important. You're really just trying to dig in and learn from each other. I've been very fortunate to have absolutely outstanding mentors at every step of my education. In other fields like medicine, let's say, there's this inbuilt practice of residency or whatever. But in engineering, there's an expectation that you just show up and learn how to apply the stuff that you learned in school immediately. And the only way that that's really successfully done is when you find somebody who's more senior. They can be younger. That's the age is irrelevant. It's just a question of whether they have the experience in the field. And kind of most importantly, you have to be able to form some kind of friendship. When you're in graduate school or you're doing academic research, there's huge challenges in front of academics, and they're very important problems that we need to solve. But we also have to have the patience to be able to take a piece of the problem off and really learn a lot about it. When you're in industry, you can't take a piece of the problem. Somebody calls with a problem and you have to solve the whole thing. The answer can't always be, I'm sorry, there's no answer right now. You've got to be able to do something. And when I started in industry, that was incredibly intimidating. But after the first couple of times of actually having a real answer with a tangible result, maybe there's steel in the ground after this, you know, we actually changed something. I mean, you can't get that experience or excitement, I can't at least, any other way. I think that I was ill-equipped coming into industry to really use strong project management tools and understand how to take the knowledge that I had and deploy it right away. I see a lot of people that are working in industry or have come in fresh that don't have strong project management tools, and it is part of every aspect of engineering. It doesn't matter how good you are at differential equations. What matters is if you could sit down with a group of people, scope out a problem well, define actions that need to be completed, execute, and then solve the problem. If somebody was asking me if they wanted to go into engineering, or if I was trying to encourage someone to, you'd really have to look at what the motivation is. Usually the people that enjoy it are sticking around because they like this process of identify the problem, figure out what solutions already exist, figuring out what needs to be done, and doing it, and using those tools that are out there. If you want to go into engineering, that should motivate you.